Hey, hi, I'm the kurta guy.
Hey, hi, I'm the big black t-shirt guy. Please don't write that as my name. My name is Arthur. I'm usually better when the camera's switched off.
And he's also a filmmaker.
Yes.
Both of us love watching movies.
And we went to a film school.
No. So I am a movie buff and Atul is a proper movie guy. Like, he actually works in movies.
Yeah, I mean, it's there in process.
So we have very different liking for movies. So we thought, why don't we share our list of movies and see how each one reacts to them.
I think there's gonna be a bridge, dude. I'm like meeting you halfway here. Let's see.
Welcome to the Filmy Exchange program, and we're gonna share movies from 5 categories. Category number 1, world films or festival films.
Category number 2, Hollywood films, mainstream English stuff.
Category number 3, animation.
Category number 4, Hindi films or Bollywood.
And category number 5, regional. It could be Malayalam, Kannada, Telugu, Tamil. So we're gonna give each other trailers of the movies and see how each one reacts to it.
Yeah, and hopefully we'll be able to finish this call without Vivid saying, "What are you showing me?"
Okay, category number 1, world films or festival films? Go for it. What do you have?
Okay, for world film, dude, this is horrible to ask a person who watches films like me to say that, hey, pick one. And this is the nightmare.
I know.
We're going to do City of God, which is a Brazilian crime film. Shot so well, it's won festivals. And I think if there was a gangster film to ever see, I think this would be it.
Famoso trio ternura.
I'm loving the vibe.
De Deus.
It's brilliant.
Dude.
Okay, I like what I saw.
This has one of the best opening sequences ever, which I don't know how they filmed. I don't know how they shot. I don't know how they edited. Because the one main character in that opening scene is a chicken.
Oh god. Okay.
I watched it recently and I... Wow, it's really out of this world.
Something you just connect to those kids, just happy, just dancing, playing soccer, and then they go the guns.
1 point, Arthur. Wait.
Okay, we don't have a point system. So I have a movie which I watched at Mumbai Film Festival. It's a movie called Chauranga.
Okay, I was at the Mumbai Film Festival with you. When did you get to watch this?
Chauranga is a movie directed by this guy called Vikas Mishra. So I remember meeting him at the film school when he came for a lecture. Yeah, we had a guest lecture for film business.
Love letter likhna aata hai tumko.
Yeah, it's, dude. See, this is. I thought I'd watch a minute of this, but this is like, it's, you know, one of those slow burns. Like, even with horror films, the trailer itself is fit like that. I'm gonna definitely watch this. Wow. And I get it, man. I get why people won't go for films like this. And me, personally, I would love to see more people go for films like this. But I get it. These are not topics that people would love to just jump into and say, hey, we will watch this.
It's good. We kind of got done with the serious stuff.
Yeah. My rest of my options are very, very decent.
So if you guys want fun movies for your watch list, Coming up. Continue watching. Category number 2.
Hollywood. This is the film because of which I think I started wanting to make films. And it's surprising. I have the DVD right here. And it's surprising what film it is.
Harry Potter.
And The Prisoner of Azkaban. I think this is a deeply underrated film, even in this series. But this film is where Alfonso Cuarón, who went on to direct Children of Men, Gravity, and Roma, he directed this, and you can just see like the vibe being different. You can see the visual effects being different, and this is the first time, like, I think I was allowed to see anything slightly scary at home. I think this came on Pogo, and there were Dementors in it. Yeah, it came on Pogo TV, and they had Dementors in it, and I was like, Dementors. And it was just scary, dude. And
is this the one with the tree and?
Yes, it's the one with the tree. It's
they travel back in time. They check themselves up.
Exactly. See, you remember it. But I think you should go watch it again, man, because it's there's a Nerdwriter video out there which is really cool about how beautifully artistically this film is done. It marks a change in the years. They're not kids anymore, they're adolescents, there's like feelings going around, there are dark stuff revolving, it just takes a tune, but this entire special effects is why I'm making films now. So yay. This is my Hollywood recommendation. Go watch it again. It's on Prime. Actually, you know what? Best time to do a Harry Potter marathon is during this pandemic.
So,
you're welcome.
At least for me personally, I watched all the Harry Potter movies, but this movie in specific is where I kind of remember all the scenes from.
Which is good, see, because they did it right. That's what happens when you bring a good filmmaker in.
I have a movie which is again not mainstream.
Because I just feel like we've exchanged characters. I was really here thinking that I'm going to be the one pitching indie films to you, and then you're going to be giving me Harry Potter and everything. But thanks, man. Thanks for doing this to me.
Which is directed by and stars the main lead of How I Met Your Mother.
Okay. Is this the one where he's a philosophy professor?
Okay, that is liberal arts. But what I'm giving you right now is I think is one of his first movies. It's called Happy Thank You More Please.
I have watched Happy Thank You More Please, but I don't remember it at all, because I think this was right after my entire stretch of How I Met Your Mother, where I was like, you know, I need more of this guy. and I ended up watching Liberal Arts first, and then I don't remember Happy Thank You More Please at all, but I'm gonna go watch it.
It's a nice, cute, happy movie.
And the cab driver, he said, the key to your life is...
Oh yeah, I remember.
Do not give
Mal
an
Ackerman has that alopecia.
I said, well, how do I do that? And he said, simple, say thank you.
I write.
Words?
Yeah, words.
This is such a good comedy drama, man. I'm suddenly like getting the scenes back again. It's such a good film.
I've seen the same character kind of follow up in Liberal Arts as well.
One of those films you just like, you can watch again like ages later when I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna eat food, feel happy about lunch, and just put a movie on and then do that. If you keep giving me more festival films and I keep giving you more commercials, I'm rethinking my options now.
Category number 3 is animation, and I love animation.
I really hope you haven't seen this, because when you get to see it, it's just gonna put a smile on your face. But because it's a 6-minute short film, more than anything. It's by Disney Animation Company, it's not one of their Pixar collaborations, nothing. It's straight up their own. It's this sweet little 6-minute short film that clocks like, I think, 6 minutes 33 seconds. Beautifully done. It's called Paper Man.
Dude. Again, it's so artistic. Like, it's 2D animation. Again, it is mixed with 3D at places, but...
Oh, yeah!
The visual looks so cool.
Dude, I finally feel like I can like... This call is a success for me, because I've given you an animation film that you haven't watched.
I love how they played around with the lighting. It's like, it's black and white, it's animation, but all the emotions are coming in through the lighting.
It's one of those films where I start saying, oh wow, this is such a pretty film. And then you get drawn into the story, which is just incredible. It's magical, dude. It's brilliant.
The movie I'm giving you is a stop motion. One of our first collaborations was doing a 10-seconder.
I have that keychain here somewhere without one of the hands. I don't know what happened. The hand didn't survive so long.
Okay, stop motion. I have a movie for you. It's a movie called Mary and Max.
I'll be honest with you. Mary and Max has been on my laptop sitting there from third year of college.
Mary and Max is a complete contrast. The thing is, it's not like Fantastic Mr. Fox. It's not like Isle of Dogs. It's very different, because it has a very close setup. And the premise is very strong. Premise is very strong and simple, and kind of plays around that premise.
Only friends with a nobless from her favorite cartoon.
Dear Mary, thank you for
okay, the animation.
I have never met anyone from Australia. Do you like chocolate hot dogs?
Where do babies come from in America?
Oh dude, I felt from watching this? It's dark, it's heartfelt, and it's stylistic as hell, even doing a drama, and that's
right.
That's something. But I don't know why I've put off watching this. It's somewhere in my computer still. I'm gonna give this a shot.
Like I think unlike something like a Kubo and Two Strings, which is like it seems seamless. The animation itself seems seamless in a movie like that. Oh, here it's very intentional. It's intentional that, you know what, we are a stop motion film.
It's very dark. It's very serious, but you're like, and you end up like smiling.
It's actually fun to see how both of us kind of didn't give a very colorful submission for an animation film.
Interesting.
Category number 4 is Bollywood.
Yeah, Yes. Or Hindi films. I don't know. People find saying Bollywood off, but hey, whatever, man. If people are calling it, we're calling it with them. My option for Bollywood is this little gem, which is again a very crucial mix of gut-wrenching drama and really hilarious comedy. It's this movie called Anand. Yeah, this guy called Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and he's a writer, director, editor, something that is me. So I've watched all of his films, and man, this guy has some things to say. And this guy, I mean, this was written with four other people, I think, but this film has Amitabh Bachchan and Rajesh Khanna in it, and it's beautiful.
I like how music drove the movies.
There were lyrics, they were beautiful lyrics, and I think Gulzar wrote the dialogues for this as well, and it's beautifully done.
I actually wouldn't mind watching this with my family.
Once you used up like three tissues wiping your tears, you give me a call saying that, hey, I'm on my fourth tissue. Because this does get sad, but it's a very happy film, which is called Anand. So, duh.
The movie I have for you, Mard Ko Dard Nahi Hota. I'm sure you watched it, but it is...
This is childhood action films and all of that.
It gives a very comic book vibe. It hits all the pop culture references. Feels like a hybrid between an Indian movie and a foreign movie.
And the funny thing about Mard Ko Dard Nahi Hota is it's a film I really wanted to watch in the theaters.
I watched it in the theaters.
Dude, I'll tell you what my favorite moment in there, and I think like since you know Tamil films as well, you know this. He says that, you know what the main problem between, he says this to his brother, he says, you know what the main problem between you and me is? You're a Kamal fan. And I don't think a lot of people have gotten it, but Vasan Bala, if you ever end up watching the Kurta Guys videos, we love you.
Category number 5 and the last category, regional. Atul, what do you have for me?
This film is called Kumbhalangi Nights. It came out last year.
I've not watched it.
Story is brilliant. The characters are brilliant. And Fahad Fasil is... I think that man is on another level.
Hey, it has the Ishka actor guy.
Yell at me, how dare you?
USA, okay, India, go!
Comparing it to Tamil movies or any of the Indian movies, they're so high on stories, they're so high on the visual aspect of it. It just transports you to that location.
You're right, you know, it's these tiny concepts or contents that's just like thrown to you and say, okay, now bask it in terms of the feel of it, in terms of the location of it, in terms of the... Not the actors, the characters.
My last movie for you is a Telugu movie called Aw.
Nah, I haven't watched it.
A lot of these Telugu movies run on formulas. So they need a character intro song, an entry, and a hero introduction, a fight.
Yes, yes.
And movies like Aw, they're kind of breaking that whole formula.
Mm-hmm.
And it's produced by Nani.
I refused to watch this film for only one reason. My graduation film was coming in. And I went to Aw set, and I really liked the set. But the debut, I think because the way you describe it as well, the director was like, see, I don't want the set to go out in public, so I'm not ready to let you use the location as well.
For a very experimental movie like this, it kind of makes super sense towards why you mentioned that.
Oh, wow. I know nothing except there's a crocodile in this film, which is so weird because the rest of the film doesn't feel like it requires a crocodile.
This is what differentiates a good trailer from another trailer, because it's cut well, but it doesn't reveal
the whole
story.
Thing, man. Trailers nowadays are like 4 or 5 minutes long, and it just, it's like, hey, here's the entire plot. Man, okay. Oh, it's on Hotstar. I'm gonna watch it.
Out of all these movies you watched, give me one movie you're gonna go back and watch right away.
I think it has to be Mary and Max, for a fact. It just, I think, it's not just because I'm in a space to watch Mary and Max finally, But I think it's because of how stylistic it is.
I'm gonna watch Kumbalangi Nights first, because I've fallen in love with Malayalam movies so much. So that is the video.
Yay!
Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, subscribe, comment, follow us on Instagram. Breathe, stay alive.
Be prepared for more Kurta Gai Kurta. Bye.
Peace.